Well, on that note, it's time to say hello to our Alpha Manager of the Day, Anand Shah, Deputy CEO and Head of Investments at BNP Paribas Mutual Fund, now joins in. Anand, first of all, very happy Holi to you as well. Welcome break for all of us in the middle of the week. First things first, I mean, the spirits are high. I think it's very colorful considering how the market has moved over the last couple of weeks. So, yes, we are inching in close to all-time highs this Holi. The question is, do you think those levels will be taken out? And more importantly, do you see these levels in this move sustaining?
Hi, very good afternoon. And yes, Fish, a very, very happy Holi to you and your viewers too. Yeah, indeed, it's a very colorful as it looks today. And coming to the markets, I think a lot of this rally has to do with, you know, what's happened, especially with US Fed and where they've taken a pause. I think
Anand, just development, but to get back to your point, sustainability of this market rally.
I think, yeah, that's what I was saying. Maybe we are a little 24 hours too early. We will have an FOMC meeting. And yes, the expectation is that the pause will continue and they ain't going to be hawkish in a hurry, given that the overall slowdown, global growth slowdown. So I think to that extent, one part of the equation, which is the global liquidity, remains intact as we speak today. Okay. But we'll know more tomorrow.
Okay. Anand, hi, good afternoon. So I mean, in a sense that, you know, the market seen such a big rally in a, you know, about a 12 or 13 day period. You've seen many market cycles. Is this, you know, start of a fresh bull market, or is this because the market was so oversold, especially in the broader market, is it just a massive relief run on the other side?
I think it's been almost 2 years that, you know, emerging markets in general were sort of facing challenges with the rates going up in US and dollar strengthening. So to that extent, the January pause and the subsequent commentary coming from US has definitely helped all the emerging markets. Actually, India has been late. Frankly speaking, YTD, if you see, most of the emerging markets are up between 7% to as high as 25%. We've been doing nothing till 15 days back. So we are just playing a catch-up as far as returns in YTD concerned. Nevertheless, over a 1 year, India is you know, in line with the other emerging markets. But yes, it's been sort of a relief rally from the 2 years of sustained increase in rates in the U.S. Fed, leading to money flowing back into U.S. and dollar strengthening. So to that extent, it's been a relief rally from a two-year-long rate hikes.
Okay, so Anand, now the point is, from here on, considering we are at these elevated levels, what should the portfolio strategy be? Because on one hand, there's this raging debate about, and you know, an apparent slowdown in the economy. Look at auto sales. Today we were speaking to Bajaj Auto, 100 days of inventory. That's what Mr. Rajiv Bajaj told us. So those are genuine economic concerns playing out, and then you have a market at elevated levels. What should the portfolio strategy be?
I think we will have to be selective, and notwithstanding the near-term challenges on the economy, we also at one end know that there has been a significant spending going on from the social sector perspective, from government's perspective, run-up to the election, but also on the infrastructure. So as we see into the earnings, frankly, we don't see too much of pessimism when we see FY20, FY21 earnings, especially led by corporate banks. But to overall say that, you know, we're not finding growth in the markets, that's not true. There are selective challenges, but, you know, that's been the case for the last 4 years. Through the last 4 years, initially it was commodity producers in 2013-14 which suffered from a price crash of oil and metals. Then you had corporate banks which suffered almost for 1.5, 2 years, going all the way till last year because of the asset quality review. And so you had corporate banks which suffered almost for 1.5, 2 years, going all the way till last year because of the asset quality review and subsequent NPAs. So yes, there are pockets where even you talk of auto today, we had a big liquidity crisis in NBFCs which sort of impacted auto sales to some extent, but also this 3-year insurance, which is an added cost at the time when there has been slowdown, has further added the, you know, agony. But I think this will also pass. We are seeing quite an upbeat, you know, expectation from both consumption space, but more importantly from the rural consumption space. So we believe it's more cyclical rather than structural. And to that extent, I think the earnings is what will be the focus post-elections, and that's where we will find pockets of, you know, good opportunities to invest into.
Fair enough. By the way, the other stock that would be in focus, apart from PNB, is Allahabad Bank. There were two banks which were defrauded the most. Of course, PNB was the one, and there was Allahabad Bank as well. And that stock also now beginning to make a move. Still in the red, but you know, it won't surprise me if that also moves into the green, and quite a bit, because that was also one, you know, the other bank where, you know, there was this Nirav Modi fraud, PNB and Allahabad Bank, and both beginning to see quite a bit of move. So, in fact, this is a big move happening now in both these PSU banks. There's quite a bit of fall in both of these after that fraud was unearthed, and now you're seeing a big rally play out in both these names. Anand, from here on, going forward, what to your mind would be the biggest risk for this market?
I think the key risks around, obviously, is crude. Crude in the near term will always remain a sort of a showstopper every now and then when we have a sharp rally in crude, and that's what happened in the month of January when the other emerging markets were actually rallying. India suffered because of a rapid rise in the crude price. So that remains one risk. The other risk being US Fed, and if at all they change their stance, that's also a risk to the markets, not as much to the Indian economy, but that remains a sort of a risk to the markets. And last but not the least is we are entering into a phase where we will have a general elections, you know, panning across 5 weeks, and it adds to its own uncertainty. And to that extent, it can be an upside risk, it can be downside risk also, but suffice to say that it will also lead to certain sort of volatility into the markets over the next 3 to 4 months.
Anand, going through some of the funds, I mean, I did notice that you have more of the staples in the portfolio. There are stocks like Asian Paints, there's Nestle, I saw, and I think the large cap fund as well. There's also Asian Paints. I didn't see too many discretionary consumer names out there, at least in the key holdings. Now, is that the call, that you are more comfortable holding staples and you stay away from discretionary? And where in this entire puzzle does auto really fit in, if at all? I didn't see too many auto names, actually, to be honest, in the top 10.
Yeah, indeed. So I think we did have an underweight position on auto. So within discretionary, auto is a very large space. But if you see beyond autos, the discretionary, be it airlines or be it multiplexes and the entertainment, that's a space we still continue to like. So overall, our largest overweight and our largest positions are in the financials, followed by consumers, within which staples continue to remain sort of a defensive in terms of earnings growth rate, and that's what we like. But you also like selectively discretionary spend, given the urban consumption is also looking up.
All right, Anand, we leave it there today. Thanks a lot for joining us. That's a view from BNP Paribas Mutual Fund.